Hello everyone, welcome again to EU Scholarship Info Day. I'm Alicia, I'm going to be your moderator for this session. All right, for the second session, I will invite Studying Hungary. Ms. Kathleen Knightley here is here to present to us about the opportunities to do your studies in Hungary with a scholarship funded by the government. Ms. Kathleen is the first secretary of education, culture, and study in Hungary. Without further ado, I'm going to invite Ms. Kathleen. Hello again, Ms. Kathleen. Nice to see you again.
Yes, hello. Good afternoon. Yes, we can speak in Indonesian or in English. It's up to you. Thank you very much for the opportunity, and I hope even though it is on Sunday and afternoon, there are many students who are interested in studying in Hungary. So. Okay, so because this event is specializing on or focusing on scholarship opportunities, I will talk a little bit about studying in Hungary in general, but in the second part of my presentation, I will focus on the Stipendium Hungaricum scholarship program provided by the Hungarian government. It's a very, very popular scholarship program for Indonesian students. The quota is 100 students per year. And last year we had more than 1,000 applications. So I was really happy. On the other side, some Indonesian students or applicants might be less happy because the persaingannya lebih ketat. Jadi pertama-tama saya hanya mau bicara sedikit mengenai kenapa Hungaria bisa menjadi tujuan atau lokasi studi yang tepat atau yang bagus untuk mahasiswa Indonesia. Mungkin semua orang tahu bahwa Hungaria atau letaknya Hungaria di benua Eropa itu sangat strategis karena berada pas di tengah. Saya mungkin minta presentasinya, Mbak Petra.
Good afternoon. Can I ask the host to set me as a co-host and I can share the presentation?
So we should ask the organizer to give Mrs. Petra Kovács from the Embassy of Hungary.
Yes, Ms. Kathleen.
Yes.
Yes, Ms. Kathleen.
So can you give Mrs. Petra an access?
Oh, yes, Ms.
So she can. Share the presentation because unfortunately I cannot share the presentation by myself because I have very limited internet access. I'm out of town now but in the meantime I just want to say that
so Ms. Petra is already in the host so she can
thank you. Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you very much.
So
Daddy, letaknya Hungaria itu sangat strategis karena posisinya pas berada di tengah Eropa. Jadi kami sering menyebut diri kita atau bangsa Hungaria sering menganggap dirinya sebagai bangsa yang bisa menghubungkan barat dengan timur. Dan memang sepanjang sejarah kita, di sini lokasi Hungaria yang bisa juga dikatakan jantungnya Eropa. Jadi memang suku Hungaria berasal dari kawasan Asia. Jadi kami dalam hati kami mungkin masih ada jiwa Asianya, tapi sekarang sudah menetap di wilayah yang sekarang sudah lebih dari 1000 tahun yang lalu. Maka Memang bisa menjadi sebuah penghubung di antara barat dan timur, dan juga mungkin misalnya budaya masak atau bahasanya itu juga masih ada beberapa beberapa yang mengkaitkan kita kami ke Asia. Jadi misalnya masakannya pedas sekali, jadi itu justru menyenangkan para mahasiswa dari Indonesia karena karena masakannya cocok. Dan juga katanya para mahasiswa yang sudah menyelesaikan masa studinya di Hungaria, bahwa masyarakat Hungaria bisa dikatakan dibandingkan dengan masyarakat lain di Eropa, bisa dikatakan ramah sekali. Nah, jadi Hungaria, luas wilayahnya kira-kira sama dengan Pulau Jawa, 93.000 kilometer persegi, tapi jumlah penduduknya jauh lebih sedikit. Bisa lihat di sini 9,8 juta orang. Dan memang menetap bangsa Hungaria atau suku Hungaria menetap di wilayah yang sekarang lebih dari 1.000 tahun yang lalu. Mungkin karena sepanjang sejarah Hungaria itu memang selalu ada yang suka menduduki wilayahnya. Pertama datang Genghis Khan dari Mongolia, kemudian ada juga Turki atau Kekaisaran Ottoman, kemudian ada juga dari barat Austria, jadi adalah monarki Austro-Hungaria, dan setelah Perang Dunia Kedua kami pernah diduduki oleh tentara Uni Soviet dan mengikuti sistem sistem komunis terpaksa selama lebih dari 40 tahun. Jadi sejarahnya juga mungkin sedikit mirip dengan Indonesia, jadi tidak begitu lancar. Jadi kami memang untuk mendapat kemerdekaan atau kebebasan itu memang harus kita juang sepanjang sejarah kita. Mungkin itu yang mengakibatkan bahwa bangsa Hungaria bisa dikatakan sangat inovatif. Jadi ada banyak inovasi yang diciptakan oleh orang Hungaria yang terkenal. Seperti misalnya komputer atau diesel engine or helicopter or the safety match, ballpoint pen, and so far, for example, Rubik's Cube is also the innovation of Mr. Erno Rubik. So, because Hungary is close to German and close to Austria, and we have a very good tradition in very close ties, not only politically or economically, but we have a strong influence on our higher education system also from Germany. So we can say that traditionally the quality of Hungarian education, including Hungarian higher education, is very good. And the Hungarian diplomas are very competitive ones. At the same time, the living costs in Hungary are much cheaper than in Western Europe. So that is why we always say that for Indonesian students, Hungary can be a very good choice, because you have to pay less for your everyday living costs, but the quality of the higher education is really good. And the structure of the Hungarian higher education system is the same as in any other countries in Europe. So we have an autumn semester from September to December, and then the spring semester from February to June. And we have the three-cycle degree structure. And I think all the other things are quite the same as in other countries in Europe. Hungarian language is one of the most hard to learn, but you don't have to without a kavatir karena per semua institusi perguruan tinggi Hungaria menawarkan program studinya sebagian program studinya dalam bahasa Inggris. Untuk sementara atau dalam tahun akademi ini, universitas-universitas di Hungaria menawarkan lebih dari 600 program studi dalam bahasa Inggris, mulai dari ilmu agraria, ekonomi, kedokteran, semuanya bisa dipelajari dalam bahasa Inggris. Dan kalau kita melihat bagaimana kesempatan belajar di Hungaria, lalu seorang mahasiswa Indonesia mencari kesempatan untuk beasiswa, saya ada kabar baik bahwa memang kami punya makin banyak mahasiswa dari Indonesia yang mahasiswa swadana dan itu sangat bagus dan saya senang. Tapi kalau ada yang tidak mampu atau tidak bisa menerima beasiswa dari pemerintah Indonesia, pemerintah Hungaria menawarkan sebuah program beasiswa namanya Stipendium Hungaricum yang pernah saya sebut pada awal acara yang sangat populer, makin populer di kalangan mahasiswa Indonesia. Kerjasama ini sudah berlanjut lebih dari 5 tahun. Jadi tahun 2016, pemerintah Indonesia dan Hungaria menandatangani MOU yang memberi kesempatan untuk mahasiswa Indonesia ambil kuliah di Hungaria. Programnya itu sudah bisa S1, S2, dan S3, dan fully funded. It means that you will have the tuition fee and also other like dormitory and also health and insurance and other things. So you don't have to pay for your studies, for your full program, even it's S2, S2 or S3. There are more than 30 Hungarian higher education institutions in this program with 450 study programs provided in English. And masa pendaftaran untuk program beasiswa Stipendium Hungaricum ini setiap tahun mulai pada pertengahan November, 15 November, sampai 15 Januari. Jadi Anda akan punya 2 bulan untuk mengajukan aplikasi. Sistem online 100%. Jadi nanti saya sarankan bisa mengecek situs stipendiumhungaricum.hu di mana semua program studi yang bisa dipilih tercatat. Jadi mungkin sudah sebelum tanggal 15 November itu ada gunanya untuk melihat-lihat kira-kira program studi apa yang mau dipilih. Pada masa aplikasi, semua mahasiswa atau semua aplikan bisa memilih 3 program studi. Apakah 3 program studi yang berbeda-beda tapi universitasnya sama, atau program studinya yang sama tapi universitasnya berbeda-beda, itu terserah para aplikan. Kemudian, setelah masa pendaftaran selesai pada pertengahan Januari, yayasan yang mengelola program beasiswa ini di Hungaria akan melihat aplikasi mana yang bisa dianggap komplit, lengkap, dan daftar para aplikan yang aplikasinya dianggap lengkap, namanya akan dikirim ke Kemendikbud, yang namanya mungkin sejak minggu lalu berubah karena ada perubahan dalam struktur pemerintah.
Halo Ibu Katalin. Tes, tes. Suaranya hilang, Ibu. Halo Ibu Katalin. Tes.
Okay, do you hear me now?
Yes, I do.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay.
I hear you fine.
So, the application of all students who completed the application will be sent to Kemendikbud, and then the Indonesian party will decide on the most the best applications, and then they will nominate about 150 students for applications to the Hungarian party, and then it will be around mid-March, and then the universities, youth institutions will conduct the interviews via Skype, usually via Skype, and then it will be until the end of April, and then pengumuman akan dilakukan sekitar bulan Juni. Dan semua aplikan yang mendapat kesempatan untuk kuliah di Hungaria bisa mengajukan aplikasi izin tinggalnya di Kedubes Hungaria di Jakarta pada bulan Juli dan Agustus, dan bisa berangkat ke Hungaria pada akhir Agustus atau awal September. Tahun akademik seperti di Indonesia mulai pada awal September di Hungaria juga. Ini mengenai, ada juga di sini bisa melihat bagaimana application timeline yang coba saya jelaskan tadi. Dan on the next picture, you can see the available study types. And this is the surface where you can apply. And before before sending or uploading the your application, you can choose which higher education institution or which study program you prefer. So it's a very useful surface on the Stipendium Hungaricum website. Next, please. Next. Yes, here you can see that basically all study fields are supported. So for the bachelor's and master's degree, we prefer agriculture, natural sciences, economics, information technology, and technical studies, but also arts and sports studies. And for the doctoral degree, you can choose any field of interest. So basically, we are really open to support any kind of field of study. We also have, for sure, the Erasmus Plus International Credit Mobility Program, in which we have more and more Indonesian and Hungarian higher institutions, higher education institutions, cooperating and working together and sending students from Indonesia to Hungary and from Hungary to Indonesia for partial studies, usually one or two semesters. Next, please. Next, please. Okay, these are the universities from Indonesia and Hungary working together on the under the Erasmus Plus program. We also offer some kind of bilateral state scholarships for those who are intending to study only for a few weeks, or maybe one or two semesters, or conducting any scientific research. I would advise to try to apply for this bilateral state scholarship. Next, please. We also have a special scholarship for the Hungarian diaspora. I don't think that there are many people or students in Indonesia who belong to the Hungarian diaspora, but it's just to let you know that we try to give some kind of support to foreign students with Hungarian identity to pursue their studies in Hungary. So it's a nice thing as well. Next, please.
Excuse me, Badalin. You have 2 minutes left to finish your presentation.
Okay, thank you. So just very shortly, these are the main study cities in Hungary. Budapest in the middle, you can see Pécs, Veszprém, Debrecen, and many other very nice cities. Next, please. Next. Yes. And this is this might be the most important part of my presentation, the links for the Study in Hungary website and also for the Stipendium Hungaricum website. On the Study in Hungary website, you can find all relevant information, including living cost, culture, types of accommodation, weather information. On the Stipendium Hungaricum Scholarship website, you can find all the study programs provided in English for Indonesian students, and you can find all relevant information about the application procedure. So thank you so much, and I'm ready to answer your questions.
Thank you, Katalin, for a very comprehensive presentation. I bet a lot of our students and our audience here are interested to get to know more about the opportunity to study in Hungary with the stipend Hungaricum, sorry if I pronounce it wrong, scholarship. That's really awesome. Okay, we have several questions here. First question. Is a master program student with a scholarship allowed to take internship program or a part-time job?
Yes, all our students participating in the Stipendium Hungaricum program or any other scholarship program or Master Sasvadana Juga. Diberi kesempatan untuk bekerja sambil kuliah atau kerja sambil kuliah sambil kerja dan sebaliknya, itu batasnya 40, bukan 20 jam per minggu, kecuali di antara dua semester. Jadi pada musim panas, waktu masa kuliahnya terhenti, bisa ambil lebih banyak jam kerja, mungkin bisa sampai 40. Tapi selama semester genap atau ganjil itu terbatas 20 jam.
Okay. Thank you for your answer. Second question. A scholarship covers student to learn Hungarian language?
Yes, you can you can and you have to actually from last year you have to learn some Hungarian for 1 year during your first year of study, you can take Hungarian classes in your host institution.
Nice, thank you. Third question, what is the quota for the scholarship Stipendium Hungaricum for Indonesian students per year?
Why?
What is the quota?
Okay, so because every government has some limits in providing financial needs for foreign students. You should know that the Hungarian government established this scholarship program, the Stipendium Hungaricum, in 2013, and providing free study opportunities for more than 70 countries around the world, including Indonesia. And during the first year, Indonesia had a quota for 50 students a year. And then because it became so popular, the quota was raised, was doubled, and now it's 100. And most countries get quota for less students. So I think it's a very nice thing that Indonesia has this 100 per year quota. And they provide this scholarship for more than 70 countries. So it's a huge scholarship program and very generous one, I think.
Yeah, I agree completely. So let me rephrase that. It's 100 students per year?
Per year from Indonesia, yes.
Wow, that's amazing. So there's a lot of opportunity for our audience here maybe to apply and have a high chance to get accepted, Ibu.
Yes, that's correct.
All right. Ibu, this is the end of our presentation. Thank you very much for your time. It is very clear and elaborated. I hope everyone who joins here get involved and then get to know more about studying in Hungary and also most importantly about the scholarships, Stipendium Hungaricum. Thank you, Ibu, for your time. I'll see you around.
Thank you so much. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.